what is the great sin that would prevent you from being raptured when Jesus appears in the sky to take his people home? Or if you don't believe in a pre-tribulational rapture, I do, but if you don't, then what would prevent you from being safe when Jesus comes back to this earth and brings judgment? The answer may surprise you. We have to go back to the book of Genesis to begin looking at it. We're going to talk about Noah and the flood. And if you don't think that Noah was a literal man or that the flood really happened, then you must believe that Jesus is a liar, because Jesus talked about Noah and the flood. As a matter of fact, Jesus used it to tell us what the problem would be for people not being ready when he returns. Here's what Jesus said. He said, as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be in the coming of the Son of Man. People were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, and they were completely unaware until the flood came and swept them all away. Did you hear that? Even though we know for a fact that the flood came because people were so evil, there was so much wickedness, Jesus, when he talks about it in reference to his second coming, doesn't mention any particular horrific sin other than the sin of ignoring God. He said they were unaware until the flood suddenly came and they were all taken in judgment. Now, in the book of Luke, Jesus adds that during judgment, people are sometimes just buying and selling, planting and building. So my question for you is this. Are you just getting up every morning and doing your thing? Kind of just cycling through life? You go to school, you go to work, you entertain yourself, you go shopping, you go out to eat. Because if you're doing that with no thought for God, no realization that Jesus is coming back and that life should revolve around him because he is the Savior, then you may be swept away in judgment. Peter corroborates this in 2 Peter chapter 3. He says, in the last days, there'll be scoffers. People who say, hey, it's been 2,000 years. Jesus hasn't come back yet. He's not coming. But then Peter goes on to tell us, yes, these people forget that the flood happened. And they don't read the word to understand that there's going to be coming a judgment of fire. So the greatest sin that may prevent you from being safe at the second coming of the Lord is the sin of being unaware, being oblivious, because you don't really have relationship with Jesus. You're not talking to him. You're not loving him. You're not looking for him. That's the greatest sin. And you can confess that and have relationship with him today.